Today I'm going to do a really quick playthrough of a new game I got from Kickstarter called Dragon Slayer, the dice game with a twist, by David Mortimer and put up by Indie Boards and Cards. These are the same people who do games like Coup and Resistance and Avalon and Flashpoint and on and on. They do a whole bunch of games and they put out really good mostly group games, but every game group I've ever been in, when you pull out one of these games, everybody enjoys themselves. They're really fun. So let's get to this. First off, everybody who's playing will pick a little character. Now this is a 2-6 player, I believe, game. Or 2-5. Yeah, 2-5 player. So everybody is going to get, well, it's marked 2-5, but there are 6 colors. I believe that's simply the Kickstarter edition. I believe when the retail comes out, there'll only be 5. I don't know what color they'll get rid of, but they'll probably get rid of one of these colors. But for the purposes of today's game, I'm just going to pick the little green guy. So everybody will pick their little warrior, and I guess keep it in front of you to remind you what color you are. And then you'll also take a blank D6 that's the color of your player and put it on or next to the scoring board. Every time you score, you move your little guy along. There are three scoring boards. So when you're just playing two players, you use one board and give each player one of these to keep track of their dice. As players go up, you're just gonna have to keep track of it yourself without the help of this, because they didn't put more than 3 cards in here, which are postcard sort of quality, so they're not bad. So I'll take my little green die, put it up here. I'll take my hunt, put it down here, and I guess, I don't know, right there. Since I'm playing by myself, it doesn't really matter. I'm just gonna show basically one version. So you take your player hunting die, or your warrior hunting die. It's got 2 shields, a fire breathe, so you could also cause an attack, and then 3 axes, which is you attacking the dragon. And they're all the same. Then you're going to choose which dragon you want to hunt. The red being the hardest, green being medium, and blue being the easiest, being most likely to get. So there's 4 dragon heads and 2 mountains. So no attack on that. There is 4 tails or 5 tails and 2 no. Yeah, 4 tails. Sorry, I lost count. 4 tails and 2 mountains, so no attacks on that. And I'm guessing 4 wings and 2 mountains on that. So there's no attacks. So the blue dragon will not attack you. You only have the opportunity to attack yourself. Where's that? That one. That is a dragon attack. So if you roll that, you're hurting yourself. So you take all 6 dice. Roll them up. Let them go. So I've got a dragon attack. Me attack, me attack, a head, a tail, and a mountain. Now, since there's a dragon attack, I need to block that with a shield, but I don't have a shield. So the dragon gets through, so I'm losing 1 die, and since it's that one, I'll just put it up there. I keep any dragon parts that I catch. So I found his head, and I found his tail, and now I need to find his body. And I'm still searching in the mountains. So I take the dice that I left over, roll them up, and I'm still searching. But if he would attack, I was defending, and I could attack him. So I continue to search. When you start a hunt, you have to keep hunting until you either die or find the dragon. Find and slay the dragon. So again, I'm still searching. And here we go. Ugh. But he's attacked me twice. I found the whole dragon, but he's attacked me twice. I've died. So that's it. For my turn, it would go on to the next player's turn. So we're gonna say it's gone around everybody, and it's back to me. And I'm gonna try and get that blue dragon again. And here we go. So his head there. And tail. He's attacked me once. And I've attacked him twice. I lose that. But my one axe has killed the dragon. So I've defeated the dragon, and I could take his head as a trophy and put it right here. Now there are two things that can happen. One, I can continue to hunt on my own volition. Just say, I want to continue to hunt. In which case, I'll pick another dragon. Maybe the green, the red if I want a challenge. Or I can say, I don't want to hunt anymore. I just want to score my 2 points. The problem is, the next player can challenge me. And that means, if I decide I don't want to continue, the player who challenged me is going to get 5 points. I only get half my points, so I would only get 1. But if I accept his challenge, I continue to hunt, and I get double points. So I would then pick the dragon that I want to hunt next. So let's say I want to hunt the green dragon next. So I'll take my 6 die again. And I've got 2 attacks, and a defend. And I've got his head and his wings, and I can continue to search. So I take all four of these dice, roll again, still searching. Here we go. I need a tail. There's his tail. And he's attacked me, but I have 2 shields to defend. So he does not attack. I've defended, but I haven't killed him. He's still running around. Now I don't have to find him. I just have to kill him. He's attacked, but I've defended, and I've attacked him. I've killed him. So I take the green dragon as a trophy. And I can only be challenged once per round. So since I was challenged, that person doesn't get their 5 points, but I get double. So I get 12 points, I believe. Or maybe it's just the next dragon. I was wrong. So I get my original 2 points for this dragon. Then I was challenged, so I get double points for the remainder of the round. So I get 8 points for him, for a total of 10 so far. Now, I can stop and score, and I don't have to be worried about anyone challenging me, because I've already been challenged. I've already defeated this challenge. Or I can continue to hunt and go for the big guy and go for max points. So let's, just for shits and giggles, let's do that. Let's go for the hat trick. So, all 6 dice. And I've got his head. He's attacked me twice. I lose a die for each undefended attack. So these would actually go to the next player because I've lost them totally. So I've got one dice left. I don't know if I'll be able to do it. Let's try it. I might get lucky. No, I did not get lucky. He killed me. He killed me coming out of the cave. I only got his head and his wings. So that means, I believe that I don't score anything. So I pressed my luck. I've tried to kill all three dragons, and I failed. So these trophies are null and void. I do not get them. I score no points, and it goes on to the next person. And that's how it goes. You do your turn, the next player does his, and we race to 40 points, or 50 points, or 20 points, or whatever we want to score to. It doesn't really matter. We decide. So that is it for Dragon Slayer. So that is it for Dragon Slayer, the dice game with a twist.